Hi everyone, in this video we're going to look at the new features included in the Power Query September 2014 update. There's four main new things in this release. The first one is a significantly improved experience or dialog for handling data source settings. Let's go take a look. So as you may already know, data source settings is available in the Power Query ribbon tab under the Machine Settings group. If you've used this dialog before, you may have realized how it was quite painful to find items within this list. There was no possibility to search for items as there is now. For instance, I could start typing in the name of the data source and it will automatically constrain or restrict the list to just the items that match that item. Additionally, I can also sort by different criteria. The default sort criteria is name or path to the data source, but I could also go and sort by the kind or the type of the data source. For instance, right now it's sorting alphabetically and it's showing Exchange, followed by MySQL, followed by OData, and then SAP, SQL Server, and so on and so forth. A few more improvements in this area, and for instance, let's go and select this SQL Server database. You see how now it's possible to edit and delete the entry from these buttons down here, and also from right click. Another option on right click is to copy the path to the clipboard, so I could easily then reconnect to this data source or copy it to another application. But if I go into edit, this is the other big improvement on this specific functionality. You may remember how before the only possibility was to edit the credentials or edit the privacy level if it had been set from the list in the previous dialog. Now I could independently delete the credentials or edit them without affecting all of the other settings. Similarly, I could control the encryption connection for databases, which is something that was not possible before outside of credentials. The other thing that I could do here is customize the privacy level, and something that's very important as well. Now I could go ahead and specify the privacy level in this dialog, even if I had not specified it before, which was not possible in previous releases. Finally, for databases, we also expose at top level the ability to revoke approvals for native database queries, which is something that also was not possible before. Before, it was only possible to see whether you had approved native database queries or not for a specific data source, but in order to revoke the approvals, you will have to remove the entire data source entry. Another very important feature included in this dialog now is the ability to select multiple sources and go ahead and click delete. So let's go and select these four all data feeds, and I could just click delete and this will automatically delete them. Finally, I could also select a group of entries and click edit, and that would give me the ability to edit the common settings across all of these sources, which in this case are just the privacy level. So I could do a bulk edit of privacy settings, privacy level for a bunch of data sources at the same time. That's it for the first feature, data source settings. Let's go and talk about the next two on the list, which are within the editor, the query editor dialog. The first one is the ability to insert index column and customize this operation. So if we go back into Power Query and connect to a table in this database, let's go and find my database. Let's say Northwind. And let's pick categories and let's go into the editor, the query editor experience. So you might remember how in previous releases it was possible to do an add index column operation, which would effectively insert a new index column starting at zero and with one increment between rows. Now we've added this dropdown with additional options, so you could still do the from zero starting at zero index, but now you could also do starting at one, or you could do a custom index and specify both the starting value or the starting index and the increment to give you a much better flexibility in what you can do through in the insert index column. So now let's go ahead and load this into the workbook. In this case, let's load it to the worksheet. And the next set of improvements that I want to show are related to the query navigator in the editor. This is something that we released in the previous update, in the August update, and it got very positive feedback from all of you. So we'll just continue to add more capabilities to this query navigator. So let's go back into my categories query and let's open the navigator. We've added a few additional options on the context menu. So by right-clicking on a query, now you could do things like duplicating these queries, or I could go ahead and start creating groups. And I'm going to create my group number one. And now I can start moving queries to that group or creating subgroups within this one. The other thing that I could do from here is also move queries up or down within the list, and also being able to delete these queries. These were things that were always possible from the workbook queries task pane back in the Excel window, but they were not available in this query navigator that we just added last month. And finally, the last improvement in this update is the ability to disable the update notifications. So if you've been a Power Query user for a while, you might have seen the update notifications show up in the system tray when you launch Excel, down here, like right next to the clock. Now we've added the ability to turn off those notifications, so you would still have the update button in the ribbon available to you, and it would light up when there's a new update. But some people have complained that showing the update notification in the system tray was a little bit annoying, especially because it was showing up every time that they were launching Excel, even though they were not interacting with Power Query. So now you could disable this update by going into the options dialog. You have a new update notifications area, and it would let you control with just that checkbox whether you want to show it or not. Moreover, if you were doing something like automatic deployment to several machines, you could automate the setting of disabling this update notification by passing a new command line parameter, disable update notification equals one, to the Power Query installer. All right. That's it for this update. It's a little bit lighter weight than the other ones in terms of new features, but you'll also notice how there's several new bug fixes and other improvements, little improvements here and there. So as always, I hope you enjoy it, and please keep your feedback coming. Thank you so much, and see you later.